¿Alguna vez te has preguntado si nos han visitado los extraterrestres? Buenas noches, sean bienvenidos a Milenios Perdidos. Muchas teorías de conspiración afirman que los extraterrestres no tan solo han visitado nuestro planeta, sino que ya están entre nosotros.
No tengas miedo.
Pero siendo honestos, muchas de estas historias son muy difíciles de creer, pero hoy tomaremos en cuenta una que tal vez te hará cambiar de opinión. Boyd Bushman era un ingeniero del Área 51, el cual en su lecho de muerte confesó que los Estados Unidos ya había hecho contacto con los extraterrestres, pero aparte de su palabra, también contaba con fotos para demostrar que lo que decía era cierto. Bushman afirmaba que en la Tierra habían dos especies de extraterrestres, pero que una de ellas era más amigable que la otra. En su confesión dice que el gobierno debería desclasificar esta información y hacerla pública para que los ciudadanos sepan la verdad. Bushman asegura que unos 18 extraterrestres están en el Área 51 y que estos tienen poderes telepáticos. El único problema con esto es que la única evidencia con la que cuenta son sus fotografías, y muchos críticos aseguran que los extraterrestres en las fotos bien podrían ser falsos. A pesar de ser un ingeniero sumamente inteligente con patentes a su nombre, muchas personas creen que Bushman simplemente estaba senil, pero muchos otros piensan que estas acusaciones son simplemente una campaña de difamación para desacreditar a Bushman. Si miraste el video anterior, sabrás que este no es el único ingeniero que trabajó en el Área 51 que afirma lo mismo. El expresidente Bill Clinton dijo: "No le sorprendería para nada si los extraterrestres estuvieran entre nosotros", e inclusive cuando ejercía como presidente visitó el Área 51. Con personas en puestos tan importantes asegurando o pensando lo mismo, hace que te plantees si lo que dice Bushman es cierto. Aquí te dejo parte de la entrevista de Bushman para que juzgues por ti mismo.
They called us in, went into the Oval Office, and President Eisenhower was there, and Nixon, and they said, we called the people in from MJ-12, from Area 51 and S-4, but they told us that the government had no jurisdiction over what they were doing. So being a general, past general, you didn't tell them to go to hell without any real good reason, you know. Mm-hmm. So he said, I want you and your boss to fly out there. I want you to give them a personal message. He says, I want you to tell them, whoever is in charge, tell them that to get in, they have this week, coming week, to get into Washington and to report to me, and if they don't, I'm gonna get the first army from Colorado and we're gonna go over, we're gonna take the base over. I don't care what kind of classified material you got, we're gonna rip this thing apart.
Eisenhower was going to invade,
yes,
Area 51.
Yeah, with the first army. They took us the 13 or 15 miles south to S4, and like different garage door openings. Okay. And in these garage door openings, they had like different saucer crafts. The very first one had the Roswell craft in. It was kind of crashed up, but apparently every alien that was in it died except for a couple. Well, the Roswell craft was really strange because it looked like real heavy aluminum foil. We could rock next to it and you could rock it. The whole thing probably weighed 150, 300 pounds.
Could they tell what the source of power was of this craft?
Yeah, it was a like a reverse gravitational thing of some kind. In fact, one later on, I got the mathematical code for reversing gravity in a 3x5 card. I guess there are different types of grays and so on.
How did you see that evidence?
Well, at the later on at S4, we viewed the autopsy film. And then the colonel said, what we've got in here is we're interviewing a gray alien. Well, I thought, boy, we had no idea we were going to see the real thing. All we saw was film.
You had to have a little bit of heart racing
yes.
at that moment.
My boss was able to go in and had a, like a partial interview with him.
So what did this gray alien look like? Could you describe him a little bit?
This one looked a little bit oriental. No, it didn't look human as far as the skin tone and basically the shape of it and the size.
How was its head size compared with a normal human, for example?
Brain was kind of a little bit bigger. Mm-hmm. And some of them, nose was very, very small. And the ears were just like holes. Mouth was very small. To go back and tell the president they actually had one.
So he did not know at this point
no.
if there was an alien
no.
at S4?
No.
What did you do then at Area? Were you done or did you have other things to do with
yeah,
S4?
Yeah, so basically we were kind of done. Went back to Area 51.
Mm-hmm.
They took us into the main building. And there we saw a U-2, which of course we didn't know existed.
Mm-hmm.
And a model of the SR-71.
Yeah, the Blackbird.
So, but like I mentioned earlier, it was not a model of the current Blackbird.
It was an earlier version.
But an early version.
Did you go directly to Washington after this?
Yes.
Or did you go somewhere else? How did they get, did you fly regular airline?
We flew back to the commuter plane back to the air base.
Mm-hmm.
And then took President Eisenhower's Lockheed Electra back to Washington. Well, we met with him in, the second story of the old OSS warehouse building. And Eisenhower and Nixon were there, and also Hoover was there. So he asked us what was going on, and we told him about the alien whole situation and the black projects and so on, and he was just totally shocked. He appeared for the first time to be worried,
mm-hmm.
you know, like he was worried.
I would think that Eisenhower would, I mean, he certainly knew that flying saucers were real.
Yes.
He knew that there were aliens. So I guess I'm just wondering, what would he have been, you know, really surprised about?
Surprised about the black programs. Eisenhower said, got to keep this thing completely secret.
Mm-hmm.
You know, can't talk about this.
Your actual name is, I mean, the name you grew up with, that was a different name than what
yes,
you had in the...
I never used it in the CIA at all. Linda Moldenhauer's phone call, her phone was tapped, and they got my phone number, and through the telephone company, they're able to find me, and so on.
When they found you, what happened?
I was going to a grocery store. Two guys in a black suits come out of a black Lincoln town car and came over to see me.
Mm-hmm.
And they told me that I better not publish anything or talk to Linda about any more things. So at that time, I did, you know, I stopped.
That was enough to intimidate you?
Yes. Rather remain anonymous. Never show my face on anything.
Really, thank you for doing this.
Yes, this was, I guess, kind of a good idea because I feel much better having talked about it, I kind of feel like there's a load off my shoulders.
Really?
Because I had an awful lot of secrets that I had kept over the years.
¿Qué piensas de lo que dijo Bushman? ¿Te parece verdad o simplemente se lo inventó todo? Déjame saber tu opinión en los comentarios. Recuerda suscribirte al canal para más videos como este. Y sin nada más que decir, recuerda seguir en busca del misterio.
Tu sol está tan resplandeciente, a mi corazón te ha encantado.